the presentation, and we try to see some real structure. Indeed, here you can see that we have a main river. I don't know if you are able to see that this is the natural river. Natural. But also, so of course the river go up to its mouth here. But also we can see here a kind of strange river. As you can see here, here we have a kind of straight river. Then here we have also this part and also to this part. So we can realize that here something strange exists. Indeed, it is really clear that this is a natural river, but it is also clear that it is man-made, artificial channel. So here we should have a kind of hydraulic structure, then that when the water discharge flowing into this river is higher than a given level, then the water discharge is conveyed by this artificial channel, and only a part of this, so we can call this one Q star and this Q tilde, and this is Q dot. Indeed, this deviation has been deployed in order to improve the hydraulic safety of this urban area. So this is an urban area. So this is exactly the same configuration that we described yesterday, just to understand. If we make a kind of sketch, here we have a water discharge, here we have an urban area. We can think to improve the safety from an hydraulic point of view of this area by deviating a part of the total water discharge. So if I call this one Q star and this one Q, sorry, this Q tilde and this Q star, of course Q star is lower than the total amount of the water discharge. So actually this is exactly the same configuration, and just to take a look at the deviation, so this is the natural river. So this is the natural river, and this is the man-made channel. And if you look at this section, it is almost clear that the section is something like that. So we have the main channel. I don't know if you can catch this thin line that is in the middle of this channel, and this part, this point, and this point are this one and this one. So this one and this point are most probably this point. So we have a kind of artificial channel, and here we have the speedway. So this structure is aimed to deviate a portion of the water discharge coming from the main river. So actually when Q dot is higher than a certain level, only a part of the water discharge flows downstream, Indeed, a portion that we called Q tilde is flowing into the man-made channel. And just to take a closer look to this hydraulic structure, we can see here the main lever. At the moment of the picture was taken, Q tilde is equal to zero. Indeed, we can see that this is dry, but when the total water discharge increases and then exceeds a given threshold, then Q star starts to cool, and then the water discharge comes here. Just a picture that I taken some time ago. Here we can show, we can see the piles. These devices are used to move the gates. So these are the gates, le paratoie in Italian. So the spillway, we can see here the downstream part of the spillway, is used with the gate. So actually we have a kind of this situation. We have this one, but also we have the gate that is this one. Just to take a look from upstream, this is the gate, and you can see also a measurement tool in order to gain insight about the free surface elevation. So just for example, this is 17.5 meter above sea level. So this is the actual elevation of the free surface. So when the flow occurs, we can show, so we have here the hydraulic jump and so on, we can see the elevation of the free surface. But we can have also some other examples. So just for example, here we are talking about the deviation of the water discharge in order to deviate a part of the total water discharge and make possible the flow on into an artificial man-made channel. But yesterday we described also another kind of solution. If we have here a Q-tot, here we have an urban area. In order to improve the safety from an hydraulic point of view of this urban area, it is possible to deploy a kind of spillway here in order to make a water body existing upstream, and then the incoming water discharge is decreased due to the presence of this water body. And this is the case. This is the case. Okay. Here we have the incoming water discharge. Here we have the water body, that is this one. And somewhere, actually here, we have the outlet water discharge. So, I mean, if this is Q, if we know QI, so the incoming water discharge, we can compute, and we are able to compute, of course this one goes to zero, we can compute Q outlet. So this is QO and this is QI. And actually here we should see a spillway. And in this case, we can see, first of all, First of all, a particular thing. Indeed, this is QI. So this is the section in which the water discharge enters the lake. But here we can see a strange thing, as you can see here. Indeed, this river not only conveys water, but also sediments. And then, when the velocity drops, here the velocity is very low, this is sediment that we called, that we said that induce the problem of siltation. So if we wait several years, the water body fills not only with water but also with sediments. On the other hand, so we are looking at this part, but on the other side, here, we have the spillway. Here I have the spillway. Spillway. So in the downstream part, we have the spillway. Here we have the area in which dissipations occurs. Dissipations or dissipations occur. And this is called, usually, the stilling basin. So, an area where the energy of the flowing water is dissipated. And then the water starts to flow in the downstream reach or river, what you want. So here we have, as you can understand, the spillway directly on this structure that is the dam. So I just switch to Italian because it is important. Come vedete, qui lo sfioratore, qui vabbè avete capito che questo è in inglese stilling basin, può essere tradotto in italiano come bacino di dissipazione, e infatti abbiamo detto che qui avvengono le dissipazioni. Ma la cosa importante è che, come vedete, in questo caso lo sfioratore è ricavato direttamente sulla diga, o su quella che può essere chiamata in generale l'opera di sballamento. Why we can deploy the spillway directly on the dam? Because the dam is a concrete dam. So, when the dam, and I guess you know what I mean when I say dam, when the dam is made of concrete, then the water can flow on the crest of the dam. But this is not always true. Indeed, if we switch to another similar case, in which now the flow is of course in this direction, so here we have Q, E, and here we have Q, O, you can guess that here we have a different kind of dam. Indeed, this one is not made of concrete, but of earth in general. So the water cannot flow over the dam itself. So we need to solve a problem. This is the dam. So you can understand that the dam has a section more or less like this one. So here we have the core of the dam. So we have material, very fine material, in order to allow, to make impossible the water to flow through the dam. And here we can have also a kind of protection. But the more important thing is this one, the core of the dam. Then in this case the water cannot pass over the crest of the dam. Indeed, if an overflow occurs, this dam can collapse. Then we need to use a spillway located somewhere else. In this case, on one side of the dam, not directly on the dam, but on the side of the dam. And here again, we can see the stilling basin here, and here we have the spillway. And yesterday we have seen also that we need to connect the downstream part to the upstream part by means of a chute. In italiano è uno scivolo, quindi abbiamo, quando le dighe sono fatte in terra, le dighe in terra, diciamo in materiale sciolto, hanno un'anima impermeabile, però l'acqua non può passarci sopra. Queste dighe non possono essere sormontate. È una cosa pericolosissima che una diga sia sormontata, perché se la diga è sormontata, la diga crolla. Capite con quanti problemi. E quindi quello che dobbiamo fare è realizzare lo sfioratore non sulla diga, perché la diga non può essere sormontata, ma da qualche altra parte. In alcuni casi lo spillway può stare anche proprio su un fianco del lago, ad esempio. In questo caso è messo da un lato, quindi qui abbiamo lo sfioratore, che è questa parte, abbiamo ancora una volta il bacino di dissipazione, e tra lo sfioratore e il bacino di dissipazione c'è quello che ieri abbiamo chiamato in inglese chute, che in italiano può essere tradotto come scivolo. Scivolo perché è una zona, è una parte molto pendente. If we look closer the spillway, we can see the tree part. So, here we have the spillway. Here, downstream, we have the stilling basin, as you can see here, this one. So this is the stilling basin, and this is the chute. Let's try to discuss about this strange shape of the spillway. First of all, we can observe that we have two different parts. The first one with gates, and another one, this one, in which the flow is free. So without gate, free flow, as we can see here. We can guess that if we make a section, just for example here, we should see something like that. Also here we have the chute, and the chute is a high slope channel. So the velocity of the flow can be very, very high. We can reach something like 25 meters per second. I mean about 100 kilometers per hour. So a very high velocity. So at the end of the chute, we have a kind of macro roughness. So we have the deployment of a kind of large disturbance to the flow in order to increase the dissipation. Then we have also this part of the stilling basin that is aimed again to increase the dissipations, and the energy that is not dissipated is dissipated in this stilling basin. Actually, we see also another part here. Actually, here we have the outlet of another pipe that take the waters into the lake, in particular here. So we have a kind of pipe that is close to the bottom, and the outlet is here. Now we can take a look to the shoot. So this is the shoot. So this is the wall, the lateral wall of the shoot. Here we have the large roughness element. Here we have the downstream roughness element. Here we have the stealing basin. And here we have the outlet of the pipe. So as you can see, we can see the different parts of the of this spillway. Actually, this is the chute. So as you can guess, the slope of the chute is very high, and as you can realize, this one, and this one are the large roughness that is aimed to dissipate energy. Of course, here the velocity is very large. You can guess that the slope increases here, more or less. Then the water depth is not so large. Indeed, the wall is something like, I guess, 8 meters, more or less. 8 meters, more or less. Indeed, where the velocity is very high, the water depth is not so high. Indeed, here the Froude number is larger than one. If we look at the upstream part, so just to understand, these are the gates. The gates, as you can see here. So we have three gates. This is 1, 2, and 3 piles. If we come back in our presentation, we are looking at 1, 2, and 3. So the gates are 1, 2, and 3. So we are looking at this part in this picture. And also we can see the free flow. So you can realize that here we have the standard, the standard profile, the standard profile that we described yesterday. Indeed, here we have this kind of section, but also here we have the section, so the profile that we described yesterday. But in this case, we have an horizontal part in top of it with the gate. So just to understand, here the we have different choice, or to have a spillway like this, or in another configuration we can think to make the spillway in this shape. Of course, from this case, from this configuration to this configuration, we have different values of the coefficient mu, but in this case we can increase the elevation of the gate, and then we can manage the overflow. So if we look here, we can use this part in order to lower the gate. And if we look here, you can see that here we have a pipe that is used to cool air. So this is an air vent. So the air vent in this case is deployed within the pile. And if we look, you can see the pipe in which the air can flow here in order to avoid the cavitation, as you can, as we have discussed yesterday. So the lesson today is a kind of practical application just to show you how the Speedway can be deployed. Just a comment about this strange shape. So we can switch to the blackboard. Actually, we can have this spillway, more or less. And you know that Q is equal to mu L 2 GH0 power 3. So H0, as you know, is the hydraulic head, if you want, or better, the distance between the elevation of the crest of the spillway and the elevation of the free surface. Now, you can guess that L is the longitudinal extension of the spillway. Now, sometimes you can have a problem in finding the needed space to deploy a spillway. So you can realize, in this case, we have the earth dam here. Earth dam here. So we have a limited space. So if the needed L is too high, we cannot deploy the spillway in this narrow area. So we can increase the length of the spillway by changing the shape of the spillway. Instead to deploy a straight spillway with the extension L, we can think to make a kind of curved spillway. So we have here. So with the same L, we need of less space. Indeed, if we make in the first case a spillway of L1, if I make a spillway of this shape, this L is L2, that is higher than L1. Of course, the water discharge, H0 power 3, is not exactly the same, because if we use a curved spillway, the mu coefficient decreases. So it is true that we need of less space, but the spillway is not efficient as the straight spillway. But this is why we need to make this strange shape of the spillway, as we can see here, this strange. So this is hell. Quindi, se non abbiamo spazio per avere a parità della larghezza del ciglio sfiorante, possiamo pensare anche di modificare lo sfioratore rettilineo con uno sfioratore curvo. Ovviamente non è efficiente come quello rettilineo, ma abbiamo bisogno di meno spazio per realizzarlo. And that's all for today.